What's going on today, guys? Tomcat here, and today we are in Spin Tires on Aussie 4x4's new map, which is called Aussie Outback. And as you can see, it's huge. He literally made it the biggest possible size that a map can be in Spin Tires, which means we're probably not going to explore the entire thing, but we're going to explore a lot of it. So he's actually here, he's on the mic, so we're going to be talking back and forth as we do in a lot of these other videos. And he's running that that crazy modified YJ, I'm running the FJ, and we're going to go ahead and set off and see where this map takes us. Now, the map itself, how long did it take you to make this map?
Well, so far it's about 3.5 weeks, and I still feel that it's not done yet.
Yeah.
It can be very, stressful.
Very stressful.
especially when you start seeing little glitches and little parts like that that just don't want to work, and then you're finding yourself sitting in that one spot trying to fix it.
Yeah, well, I think that's a big thing about making a map, but also too, a big part of making a map is getting all the textures right.
Being able to actually put up with all the bugs in the editor, because obviously for anyone that's out there making a map, has to be able to, what do you call it, deal and put up with all the crap that's gone through the
editor and stuff like that. Yeah. Well, there's that, and then there's also, for example, like when you find a little mound like that shouldn't be there, you're like, oh, that shouldn't be there.
Yeah.
That rock looks really good, though. Like, I know it's real random, but that rock shelf looks really, really good.
Yeah. And that's the one thing I wish could be done a bit better. Came out that bit too funny. But yeah, god damn it. Camera's been jumping fast.
Yeah, the camera is a little weird in Spin Tires. Anybody that's played it for any sort of amount of time, like you have or I have or anything like that, knows that this camera is not really, I don't know, super great. It's like, you can get used to it, but it's also a little weird.
But as I was saying about the rocks, if you were to, like, try and get your camera in close to that rock, you'll see that it actually starts smearing and blurring out.
Yeah.
I wish that wasn't like that, because obviously you're going to get close to the rocks.
If you're crawling on them, yeah, you are.
Yeah. And then next thing you know, you're going to see this really ugly-looking thing.
Right? Oh my god, that's a nasty-looking area out there. It's like, it looks like that'd be tricky. I don't know if I have big enough tires for it, but
that there is it, the mud pit.
Yeah, I can imagine. Is there only one mud pit on this map, or is there more?
They're slowly coming to pieces, because I'm just sort of trying to... Because, really, this image that I've got here, basically I went into this particular setup. You go look at this, it's sort of like Google Maps, in a way.
Right.
And you look at that sort of terrain from above, and snap your photo, go replace it into a few things, and basically I've gotten this terrain layout, not the coloring, from the Grand Canyon.
Mm-hmm. Well, not only that, but I think when I look at this particular map setup, I feel like it's one of those maps where you're gonna have to be, like, to really explore the whole thing, you're gonna have to be really dedicated.
Oh yeah. That's why I've sort of put out some of them spawn locators, because I know it's going to take some time for some people to get back to places.
Yeah.
It just makes it a bit faster and easier for myself for when I go to test.
Well, and I think also too, I know that for me especially, like, if I'm doing some off-roading and, you know, my vehicle gets stranded or something and I have another vehicle, but it's all the way across the other side of the map, I'm like, well, yeah. Crap, that sucks. But when you do when people do spawn locators, like some people are doing now with their maps, it makes it so much more convenient, and I really like the fact that people are using them. Have you ever had issues with like your game crashing when you use your spawn locators?
Yes, that's something because this is I haven't used the spawn locators as much, but I've been chatting away to the Cribs. That's the fella that the pre-runner playground.
Yeah,
and he's got all those wacky ass looking jumps and whatnot.
Anyway, yeah, his jumps are crazy. There were some of them that I had a really hard time getting. Although I did, there was one that I was able to do in this like crazy bus that I didn't think I was gonna be able to make it in, and it actually worked. But his spawn locators, most of the time, like 90% of the time, they work. But there's like occasionally they don't like always work properly.
Now it could be the fact of someone else being close to that spawn locator. Or you may have a vehicle in that spawn locator.
That's probably what it was.
Because I know there was a few guys on here the other day, and I went to go teleport down to Outpost 4, which I actually got to check to see if it works.
Right.
Again.
Oh, crap. I didn't know it went down on the other side like that. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, if I could be rescued, that'd be lovely. But anyways, you were saying?
I spawned to a particular a locator the other day.
Yeah.
And there was like three of them around that spot. Mm-hmm. And it was just instant crash. And I was like,
It's kind of frustrating sometimes, but like as long as you remember not to leave a vehicle nearby them, or if you're playing with people, you tell them, you're like, hey, I'm gonna use this spawn locator, please move, you know what I mean? I tipped over again.
I was gonna say too, I don't know if you know, but do you use keyboard or controller?
I kind of use a mix. Sometimes I use controller, sometimes I use keyboard. I'm using keyboard right now.
Okay, now, I don't know if you know this, hit X on your keypad. Did you know that?
Huh?
Did you know that it could release your winch there?
Oh, I didn't really, but that's kind of cool that it's a quick shortcut to do a winch release. That's cool.
Yeah. No, it's not a lot of people know that because no one actually sits there and reads through.
Nobody reads the controls, like control tips or whatever. I didn't. I never did.
Yeah, well, it took you quite some time just to get onto Spin Tires Plus.
I know. Yeah, that was my fault because I didn't realize that I needed it to do so much extra stuff. And then I got it, and then I was like, oh my god, I could never play the game without this, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because I've got my, I've got it to where, like, I just kind of leave it to where I have my dev tools on.
Yeah.
Because it's so much more usable that way. You can actually, like, work with so many more things at the same time, rather than, rather than having to make sure you spawn all the trucks you want, and then, like, I could just spawn whatever right now, you know what I mean?
That's it. I do like that, because it just means that you can go into a sesh, somebody might spawn in a crappy vehicle, ooh!
Yeah, and you can be like, I don't want to use that, you use your own thing.
That's it.
I'm surprised, actually, like, in this particular, FJ, high range is kind of slow, but, like, it's got a lot of grip. It's not fast like a lot of the other things, a lot of the other vehicles like it, but, I don't know, I kind of prefer it that way because it's more like a gear you use just to get up a steep obstacle instead of just to cruise.
That's it. Speaking of high range, I've actually really tried to work on it a lot in this map, is where you actually need to use high range.
Yeah, well, we've already had like two of those spots.
Yeah, and it's like, I like to be able to use everything for its use. Like,
well, that's a cool, that's a good point, because so many people are like, they just either use high range all the time, or they never use it. Like, they leave it alone and they never use it. But I like the idea of kind of making it so you have to use low, high, and...
So, like, at one stage, I think it was Tippy Whippy.
Yeah.
I was actually trying to make it so that you couldn't use high range.
Yeah. I remember that one. That map was sketchy.
Oh, yeah. But that was just one of those ones I was just, can't be bothered much.
Yeah, no, I mean it was, like, sketchy to drive on. I didn't mean it was, like, a sketchy map, like, the way it was made. I just mean it was, like, crazy to drive on.
Yeah.
Come on. There you go. So do you kind of just make your trails as you go, or do you kind of plan out a whole trail network and then you make it?
I just grab the brush and swig it through.
Nice.
But because I got this all off a particular site, and I was able to get an image of a real place in...
Right.
Basically, all these trails were already here.
Mm-hmm.
I just literally just looked at the camera, like the map, and... Oh, going the wrong way. Doesn't really matter.
And wrong way.
but yeah, I just... You just looked at the map, and next thing you know, I'm looking at all these tracks that basically came from the image of the real Grand Canyon.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh god. Trying to get up a hill at the moment. There we go.
But basically the reason why I didn't call it Grand Canyon is because there's so many of them already made out there.
Yeah.
Didn't wanna try and pull something off again.
And plus this kind of also gives it your own kind of feel, right? You know, it's an Aussie map. It's going to be, it's going to have your kind of branding on it, which is cool.
That's it.
Now, do you think that, I mean, what do you think the stage of this map is right now? Like, how much more things do you think you need to do before you kind of call it, like, I guess, done?
Honestly, I could sit here for another... a month or so, if I really wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
I guess it's just basically the way you want it to be set up and...
Yeah.
How much you actually want to put in.
Mm-hmm. Well, that kind of makes sense because, like, a map is never really... I feel like in the eyes of, like, a modder, a map is never really done.
No. Because, there were times where I was pushing it, my maps out to be really fast sort of thing because my editor was crashing a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And I kept losing so many maps. It was just like, ugh.
So you were just trying to get them out so you wouldn't lose them?
Yeah, basically.
It sucks that you were losing them, though. Like, how many maps do you think you actually lost?
At least 20 or so.
Jeez! Oh my god, dude, that's crazy.
Yeah, a lot of time wasted.
God, that is nuts. I would have never thought that it would have been that many maps that you had lost. Holy crap.
Yeah. And then it's just so many, as people say, the editor is so screwed.
Mm-hmm.
I was just surprised that I could last this long on the editor.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, it's that bug. You can go do a little hill here, and it will absolutely glitch the hell out.
Because it's crazy, because I've never actually played with it, so I don't really know the ins and outs of it, but I've heard from some other map makers that it's like, it's just kind of a pain to use.
Oh, yeah. There's been times I just wanted to punch my computer.
Well, I'm glad you didn't, because we wouldn't actually be playing this map if you did.
Yeah. Now, I don't know how that FJ is going to go up there.
Hold
really,
on. I'm going to try. I think she's got it.
Oh, yep.
Oh, no.
No!
It had it. It really did. It was just right there, and then... God, you see the front end come up over the edge, and then it just kind of is like, nope.
Yeah, there's gonna be an, have you taken that across any rocks or anything yet?
No, like I've never used map? It before.
Ooh, it's gonna be, interesting.
Oh, she's getting
we're
close.
We're heading over to Rock and Roller.
Okay.
I thought I'd give myself names for places now.
Yeah, I like that. I saw it on the map. I was like, oh, that's a cool idea.
Yeah.
Alright, let's try this again. Trying to get some more momentum this time. There it goes.
You.
There it goes. Oh, yeah. It's a little bit of, like, it's a little tricky, but it makes it. Like, it's one of those vehicles that you have to really try. It doesn't just walk up everything.
Yeah, you really gotta flatten the hell out of it just for it to...
Oh, yeah.
To think.
Like, I had to back way up and then put it in high to and just kind of bounce up the hill to get it to come out. But, it made it. I mean, see, that's the thing. Is like, some actual vehicles, that's how you have to be to get them up stuff.
Yeah.
Like, well. Dude, my friend's 4Runner, when we were off-roading in that, we had a couple of Jeeps and then his 4Runner, and the Jeeps just kind of flexed their way up the hill. The 4Runner had to jump up it.
Yeah.